The Venus and Neptune aspects. Woo, this is a powerful aspect when we talk about love. So the way you love, everything is divine. So you like to help those who's unfortunate, those who's suffering, those who in pain, this type of people you like to be around. And you the ultimate giver, the ultimate helper. Because love to you is unconditional. And you show your love because you know the human nature, because you're the old soul, got the Neptune. So your love is through your intuitive wisdom. So you just know what love is. You were born to know what love is. So you could be the ultimate example of love. Use your creative skills and your expression to help people. So it's through the arts. You like arts. You can identify with other people's emotions. You can identify with other people's thoughts. So you know people. So ain't too many people can say to you and tell you what love is, because you know what love is. You're born with this intuitive gift to know what love is. And this is when Venus is conjunction to Neptune. This is part of who you are. It's connected to your soul. Venus is connected to Neptune. It blend in. So when it's conjuncted to Neptune, your love is divine. Everything's divine. So life to you is happy, excited. And this is about you breathing the air and being out into nature. This is love to you. Love to you is when people get along together, when people are happy, when people feel fortunate, when you like to see people do good. This is love to you. And by you seeing the chaos in the world, you can go through it. You can feel people's pain. You can feel their emotions because you are the empath. Or you have clairsentience ability to the fullest. Because this is the placement of psychic abilities and gifts. So your gifts can help people. Your superpower. Because Neptune is superpower, the supernatural world. And Venus brings both worlds together, the supernatural and the material world together. And so Venus deals with the heart. What love is, the empath of abilities and gifts, because Venus knows people and love people and love to be around people and love to connect with people. But Neptune is a higher realm of love. So when you connect the two together, this explosion, this is unbelievable. Love is unbelievable here because you're very dedicated and loyal to your partner, and you help your partner to become the best version of themselves through the love. And your love knows no limit and no boundary. So this right here can be a placement that can destroy you too, just because of that. Because it can downplay you, and it also can make you a martyr for those who are ungrateful and those who want to utilize you and want to use you and take advantage of you. Because you're so nice, you're so giving. People always want from you. So you got to learn also when to say no, because your love is unlimited. So with this placement, you have the ability to know who lying to you, because you got highly intuitive psychic gifts. This is the home of psychic ability. And so you got all of the psychic gifts. You clairvoyance, where you can see the big picture. You know what's going on. You can see images in your mind. And you can see spirits floating around or orbs. And also you can feel when something is not right. So your environment can make you. Any environment that you go in, you can feel if it's not right. You can feel when somebody is not being loved. You can feel when somebody say that they happy when they're not happy. You can feel that. You know they lying. You are the ultimate psychic. You ultimately can feel and know people's energy. You know what people like. Because you can pick up visions of what people like. You can pick up feelings of what people like. You can also clear audience where you can talk to spirit. Or you can hear voices. Or you understand the word and the message. And you like the tone of music. So music is very important to you. Everything is musical to you. So love is sort of like music. Harmonious music. So you love peace, you love harmony, you need balance. Without that, I'm gonna get to that squares and oppositions in a minute. But this is nothing but Venus that's conjuncted to Neptune, a Venus conjunction Neptune right now I'm speaking of. Everything I'm speaking of is Venus conjunction Neptune, which is over all the aspects. This is the strongest aspects. And so every aspect has to reach this, every aspect have to connect the Venus and Neptune together. And so boom. This is Venus conjunction Neptune, which means that your love is divine. You love the bird, you love the tree, you love the plants. So this is the type of love that you have, not only with people, but your love is for life in general. And so when things happen in life that's toxic, it could rub you the wrong way. You could be escapist and just deal with addiction. And your addiction could be any addiction. It could be drug addiction, sex addiction, and it could be all the toxic ways to that destroy you because you're trying to escape from reality or separate yourself from reality. So now we're going to get to the squares of oppositions when it comes to that in a minute. But as I continue on, Venus conjunction Neptune makes your love spiritual, which means that you don't want to conform to religion or something, somebody else's ways and their thinking. You want to be freely. You want to move around freely. Your love, when you put your energy into people, you know how to bring love to environment because you know how to get creative with it. You know how to play the role and also adapt to people, adapt to environments, adapt to people, and be like a chameleon. And so you know how a person think. You know how a person move because you are the old soul. You are wisdom. So you can adapt to any environment. So that's a good thing. You can fit in with any environment and you see everybody as souls. All you see is souls. All you see is energy. All you see, you don't even look at the outside presence. You like the outside presence because Venus is beauty, but it's the souls that you mainly look at because it's Neptune, divine. So it's about the beautiful souls. It's about if the individual ain't kind, ain't nice, you can see when a person is toxic. You know what I mean? And you don't like that. See what I'm saying? You can be rebellious against those who is toxic to the environment because your love is spiritual. Your love is divine. Your love is harmonious. Your love is peace. And so you don't like toxic stuff. So you escape from that or you'll fight for that. You know what I mean? When it comes to toxic stuff. So you help those who need help against injustice because your love is spiritual. Your love is divine. Love is everything to you. You love people in general. So you like to see people win. You like to see people happy. So with that being said, love is everything to you. Being divine is everything to you. Being spiritual is very important to you because without the spiritual part of you, you feel like you're nothing. You feel like that part be missing, that life won't be important to you, excited to you no more, and you feel like you have no help without the spiritual world. So that's why you got a believe in something, or you got faith in something. So faith in something, even if it's a cartoon character, you have faith in something that will uplift you. So anything that deal with God or the universe or nature is what you love. Anything that's spiritual, gemstones, gemstone healer, because you makes a great healer. Your presence is healing people, like your cool, smooth aura. They want to imitate you because they feel pure in your presence. They feel happy because you fun loving, you're excited, and you bring love to the vibe. You know how to party, you know, in that good party, the good vibes. You know how to adapt to anybody and everything. And not only is love mental through your imagination because you're dreamy, but love is also through your emotions. Love is also through your body. So it's physical love also, and also spiritual love. You got all the elements. Because we connect Venus, which is deal with the air, and deal with the earth, which is like Libra and Taurus energy. You got Neptune that deal with fire and deal with emotion or water. So you got all the elements. So you know how to love. When you on a higher rim of Venus conjunction Neptune, you know how to love. You know how to show your love. And so for you, somebody have you in their life, because you'd be more accepting of people's ways, accepting the way people feel. So you need positive people. You don't need negative people because they'll bring you down and tear you down. Because you do anything for them, you'll be a martyr for them and die about these people. So you don't need people like this. You don't need people who won't take things from you and bring you down and downplay you. And we're going to get to the other aspects in a minute. This conjunction still I'm working on. The reason why the conjunction is important, because I'm going to show you how it play out through all the other aspects. So all the other aspects have to reach the conjunction state on a positive level. So boom. So your love is through creative, through photography, through arts, through designs. So this is what you love. You love beauty. You love people who are charming. You love people who are peaceful, people who are harmonious. And you love also those who struggle and suffer because you like to help. You like to give. And you like people who are kind. And so your love is adaptable. You adapt to anybody. I'm talking about you can fit in with anybody. And you got many ways of healing, many ways of helping, many ways. And love could be the business that you would go into that deal with love would be to a spiritual business. You open up a spiritual business, like gemstones, like sell cultural stuff that's spiritual, anything that's spiritual, like gemstones, spiritual necklaces, anything that metaphysics, anything that deal with astrology, numerology, and this is what you love. Anything that deal with divination is what you love. So this placement of the ultimate psychics, they're very good at reading people, picking up on the energy. They know your thoughts, know your emotions. You can't lie to these people. I said it over and over and over. And they're clear audience, and they got the medium ability to channel energy, because this is the home of psychic ability. This is the home of meditation. These are your spiritual gurus. These are your sages, because their love comes within themselves. So they got to look within themselves and feel that love. So love ain't only through people, it's with themselves first. So once they understand that, and they will create this balance of what love is. So they are here to be an example of love. And anybody who get with them, they have to be positive, or they got to be willing to learn how to heal and learn how to develop love. Because love is very important to these people. Because these people would do anything, will even try to heal animals and talk to plants and heal plants and channel energy. They into magic. They into some of everything. These people is good with they good with spiritual energy. They're good with energy itself. You know what I mean? They're good with the chakras, the energy centers. They're good with knowing anatomy and how the energy flow. You know what I mean? And so, boom. Now, how do Venus play out? Venus and Neptune play out through the rest of the aspects. You got Venus trying Neptune. This is your gift. Everything that I spoke of about Venus conjunction Neptune, everything I spoke of. Now, when it comes to a trine, this is your gift, your natural gift, a natural part of you to love and spread the love and to be the psychologist, to be a clairvoyant, to be the psychic, and to help people. This is your natural gift to do this. This is what you naturally do. You naturally help people. You naturally give. You naturally bring fun to your environment. You naturally have the healing presence. You naturally the one who into astrology, numerology, or any form of divination. You naturally relate to the spiritual realm. You naturally relate to the heart or what love is. You naturally imagine about love and love, the idea of love. You naturally feel what love is and know what love is, experience love. So when you don't use your gift and you ex this part of you out, this you now you wonder why you are losing, because you forget that this is naturally part of you. So natural to you. It's like your hand is on your arm, but you forget about your hand. You notice your arm, but you don't notice your hand because it's naturally a part of your arm. So this is how it operates. Well, this is your gift. Now, when you got Venus sextile Neptune, this is your potential. This is your energy. It's there, but you got to activate it. You got to go for it. You got to grab it and go for it and grow in it. And so you want to learn everything about love, everything about spirituality, everything that deal with energy, that deal with partnership, relationship, because you want to know, you want to learn everything that deal with people, everything that deals with psychic ability and clairvoyance, everything that, and this will relate to you knowing people where you can help people. You want to know everything about healing, everything about the arts, and you want to learn how to be the best at everything, which even a musician, photography, everything. And so this placement deal with photography, it deal with pictures, it deal with arts, because it's the higher version of Venus. Neptune is the higher version of Venus. So when you got Venus connected to the higher Venus, whew, it's purified, because Venus is already the heart and Neptune is the rest of the higher self. So boom, this love is very divine, very spiritual. This love don't like the material realm. So you got to find a ground so you can get you some money. Find your ground to be practical. Find your ground to stand on so you can be practical. But Venus, you tap into your Venus energy, it will also bring practicality to you, because it got Taurus. It's over Taurus too. So, boom. You got all of the gift to manifest. You got to bring everything to balance. Your emotions, your mind, your spiritual, and your earthly ways in balance. And this is how you win. And so this one you got Venus sextile to Neptune. This is your potential. So once you grow into it, you will become like the Venus conjunction Neptune or Venus trine Neptune, because you just got to activate this energy and go for it. But you would love everything that deal with love and spirituality. So you appreciate it more than the conjunction and even more than the trine. Because the trine is a natural gift. And Venus conjunction, Neptune, is a part of you. And but now, as a sextile, once you grow into it, you know the energy is there. You have these energies, but you got to bring it together. And once you master it and it becomes you, you're going to love it. You're going to love it. You're going to love it once it becomes a part of you. Because already a part of you, just got to activate it and bring it together. You're going to love it. You're going to appreciate it more than every other aspect. Unless we go into the other aspects, which is the squares and oppositions. Now, the squares and oppositions, they got a better chance after they master this aspects. They got a better chance of teaching everything that deal with the Venus conjunction Neptune. Now, when you got Venus square Neptune, Venus don't care nothing about being spiritual and don't care nothing about unconditional love, have problems with it. If Venus don't care about it, you might have problems with unconditional love, or spreading love, or giving, or being helpful, or being creative, or being expressive, or being fun loving, or being all about life. You might go through it, be depressed, be moody, and pick up on people's energy, and see ghosts and see spirits, and you think everything is demonic or demons. You see demons, that's what you probably be screaming, stuff like that. And you will go through with who you are, your divinity. Go through it with your self love. Go through it in that aspect. Because you really don't know what self-love is. Because you're going through it right now at this moment. You're going through it until you're trying to find yourself. Trying to find your divinity. And you know that divinity can bring you to love yourself and to love others. So you're always searching and seeking until later years. Until you master yourself. But if you don't master yourself, you will destroy yourself. So this is why this is important. Because the Venus square Neptune, you will go through anything that's spiritual. Anything that's divine. Not knowing what is what. You go through the religious aspects, go through everything, go from Christians to Islam, keep going around, you know what I'm saying, until you find your divinity. And so you can feel kind of lost when dealing with love, when dealing with your creative skills, not confidence enough, not strong enough, being depressed, you know what I mean? You're just going through it, you know what I mean? When dealing with love or being an empath, you feel like you're empathic one minute, and then you feel cold the next minute. So this is the feeling that you get. Because you keep going through it. Your emotions keep changing until you can't control it. You feel uncontrollable. It's so powerful right here. So you need some type of balance right here. So once you master this aspect, you'll be the best spiritual teacher. When dealing with love, you'll be the best psychic, the best astrologer, numerologist, the best at whatever you do. You'll be the best healer because you can share your experience with others and people can identify with that. Because with all you done been through, you can share how you got to the point to where you at now. So this is why I support. Because Venus conjunction Neptune placement, these people can live in their imagination, live in their mind. Because it's the dream world now. It's the subconscious. They can live there and they can create movies in their mind and create stories. So this makes you a great poet, a great writer, a great musician. So when you're talking about Venus square Neptune, after you override everything, and once you master yourself, it makes you all of this, a poet. It makes you all of everything that I stress about the Venus conjunction Neptune, the best psychic, all of that. The reason why you would be one of the best, the squares of oppositions, because y'all got to learn these lessons. This is a lesson you got to learn. You got to learn about love, learn about spirituality, learn about your divinity. You got to learn about it. You got to go through it, travel, tribulation. That's what this deals with. You can struggle with stressing yourself, struggle with speaking about love, and don't feel no love, and don't feel like you're divine, and don't care about God, and curse God out, and stuff like that. This is what it deals with. You know what I mean? And if you don't do that, if you don't curse God out, that means that you're struggling to find who you're trying to give honor to, trying to find who you're trying to worship or honor. You're trying to find your divinity. You're trying to find yourself, or you're lost in the river, or you're trying to find what love is. You know what I mean? And you might been hurt so bad that you don't want to share your love with others. You know what I mean? So this is what this deal with. So after you master this aspect, you will be the Venus conjunction Neptune on the upside, on the positive side. You definitely be that right there because you don't bring it into balance and you don't create it together. You don't conjunct it. Now, when you got Venus opposing Neptune, Yeah, Venus fighting against love or fighting for its love. You're either fighting against love or you're fighting for your love. You keep fighting for your love, battering. You can be obsessive when dealing with love. You'd be very destructive in love. Or this love could tear you down or beat you down. Just like the squares you go through where it could tear you down, beat you down. You're the one who will fight for the ones you love or fight against that. Or don't want to be loved, or don't know what love is, or want to fight your Neptunian and don't want to be divine, or don't care nothing about being divine. You just want to be about materialistic goods, materialistic wealth. Because Venus deal with wealth too. It deal with what you value. You just want to be stylish, looking good. And so, just like Venus conjunction Neptune, like to be stylish, look good, smell good, all that there. You could just want to be that and forget who you are, your divinity, lose your soul. And want to get what you can get out of people. We want to manipulate people through love. Or you might be the type that manipulate people through spirituality. The same as the Venus square Neptune. Venus square Neptune might do the same. So this is what it deals with. This is opposition deals with fighting against the spirituality or fighting for your divinity. Or you can manipulate people through spirituality. Or you can go through it to deal with anything that deals with the spiritual realm. You might see ghosts as a spirit, and don't interpret the energy because you vibrate very high in this realm. You vibrate so high that you can't control yourself. So this is why it's the opposition. You could oppose this energy. You might be tired of this energy because you don't know how to connect this energy. Or you might feel separated from your divinity. You might don't feel like you being loved or feel like you spiritual or feel you might be have the lowest self-esteem on the planet. So this is why you need to bring your Neptune energy into play. You need faith. This whole aspect, when I say Venus conjunction Neptune and all the aspects, you need faith. Faith and trust in your divinity and use the universe for everything. It's how you win. I'm talking about all the aspects. So with the Venus opposing Neptune, opposition Neptune, when you bring all the energy together and you master it, that faith will keep you strong, confidence, and you won't lose it because all the things you done been through, you're not going back. Because once you know yourself, you can never turn back because you've been through the hard times and the hardship. And that's why it's important. Just like Venus square, Neptune, the same thing. So boom, this is why like the squares of oppositions could be the best teacher. They'd be the most successful because they got a story to tell behind how they reached their divinity. The rest of them, it was easy for. From even the sextile was kind of easy for you, just had it tap into and activate it. But the sextile got a story to tell, but it won't be like the squares of opposition, but it still got a story to tell. But the trine and the conjunction don't really have a story to tell because it's naturally a part of you, and the conjunction is blended in. So, but the conjunction can go through all of the other aspects, like the conjunction can act like a sextile or a trine or a square or opposition. Now, this had to play out. That's why it's good to know the Venus conjunction Neptune, because eventually all the aspects, once you master it, it will become that. Or you use your gift, it will become that. So this is how it operates. The energy is still the same, still there. It just play out differently. Some have to work for it, go through it, hard time, and some is easy for. So with it being said, as I came to bring this light, be that musician, that poet, that healer of the world, that psychic of the world, the one who in the media, who being the one who entertaining others, who healing others, who bring excitement to others, creating stories. Yes, be that one who be that therapy to everyone that you meet and master that, or almost everyone, because you'll know who to give your energy to and who not to give your energy to, because you're just that psychic. This whole Venus, Neptune aspects, all of you, once you master it, you are definitely that psychic and have all these traits. That's all I got to say. All right, shit.